Section 28. Resonant Consonants. K, L, M, N, P, S, R, and T at the end of a word or syllable must be made resonant by joining to the end of the word or syllable a rather audible e. For instance, bandelle, gretelle, etc. A thing that no one teaches any longer, or knows or is able to do, a thing that only Betts and I knew, and with me will probably disappear entirely, is the dividing and ending of syllables that must be effected under certain conditions. It may have originated with the Italian school. I was taught it especially upon double consonants. When two come together, they must be divided, the first, as in himmel, being sounded dull and without resonance, the syllable and tone being kept as nasal as possible, the lips closed, and a pause being made between the two syllables. Not till then is the second syllable pronounced, with a new formation of the second consonant. And this is done not only in case of a doubling of one consonant, but whenever two consonants come together to close the syllable. For instance, winter, dringen, klingen, binden. In these the nasal sound plays a specially important part. The tediousness of singing without proper separation of the syllables is not appreciated till it has been learned how to divide the consonants. The nasal close of itself brings a new colour into the singing, which must be taken into account. And moreover, the word is much more clearly intelligible, especially in large auditoriums, where an appreciable length of time is needed for it to reach the listener. By the nasal close also, an uninterrupted connection is assured between the consonant and the tone, even if the latter has to cease, apparently, for an instant. I teach all my pupils thus, but since most of them consider it something unheard of to be forced to pronounce in this way, they very rarely bring it to the artistic perfection which alone can make it effective. Except from Betts, I have never heard it from any one. After me, no one will teach it any more. I shall probably be the last one. A pity. End of Section 28. Section 29. Practical Exercises. The practical study of singing is best begun with single sustained tones, and with preparation on the sound of R alone, mingled with O and U. A position as if one were about to yawn helps the tongue to lie in the right place. In order not to weary young voices too much, it is best to begin in the middle range, going upward first by semitones, and then, starting again with the same tone, going downward. All other exercises begin in the lower range and go upward. The pupil must first be able to make a single tone good and judge it correctly before he should be allowed to proceed to a second. Later, single syllables or words can be used as exercises for this. The position of the mouth and tongue must be watched in the mirror. The vowel R must be mingled with O and U, and care must be taken that the breath is forced strongly against the chest and felt attacking here and on the palate at the same time. Begin piano, make a decrescendo, then a crescendo slowly, and gradually return and end on a well-controlled piano. My feeling at the attack is as shown in the plate. At the same instant that I place the tone under its highest point on the palate, I let the overtones soar above the palate, the two united in one thought. Only in the lowest range can the overtones, and in the highest range the undertones, resonance of the head cavities and of the palate, be dispensed with. With me, the throat never comes into consideration. I feel absolutely nothing of it, at most only the breath gently streaming through it. A tone should never be forced, never press the breath against the resonating chambers, but only against the chest, and never hold it back. The organs should not be cramped, but should be allowed to perform their functions elastically. The contraction of the muscles should never exceed their power to relax. A tone must always be sung, whether strong or soft, with an easy, conscious power. Further, before all things, sing always with due regard to the pitch. In this way, the control of the ear is exercised over the pitch, strength, and duration of the tone, and over the singer's strength and weakness, of which we are often forced to make a virtue. In short, one learns to recognize and to produce a perfect tone. In all exercises, go as low and as high as the voice will allow without straining, and always make little pauses to rest between them, even if you are not tired, in order to be all the fresher for the next one. With a certain amount of skill and steady purpose, the voice increases its compass and takes the proper range, easiest to it by nature. The pupil can see, then, how greatly the compass of a voice can be extended. For amateurs it is not necessary, but it is for everyone who practices the profession of a singer in public. For a second exercise, sing connectedly two half tones slowly on one or two vowels, bridging them with the auxiliary vowels and the y as the support of the tongue, etc. Every tone must seek its best results from all the organs concerned in its production, must possess power, brilliancy, and mellowness in order to be able to produce, before leaving each tone, the propagation form for the next tone, ascending as well as descending, and make it certain. No exercise should be dropped till every vibration of every tone has clearly approved itself to the ear not only of the teacher, but also of the pupil, as perfect. It takes a long time to reach the full consciousness of a tone. After it has passed the lips, it must be diffused outside before it can come to the consciousness of the listener as well as to that of the singer himself. So practice singing slowly and hearing slowly. End of section 29. Section 30. The Great Scale. This is the most necessary exercise for all kinds of voices. It was taught to my mother. She taught it to all her pupils and to us. But I am probably the only one of them all who practices it faithfully. I do not trust the others. As a pupil, one must practice it twice a day, as a professional singer, at least once. The breath must be well prepared, the expiration still better, for the duration of these 5 and 4 long tones is greater than would be supposed. Soprano. Breath. Breath. Breath.